No, it's just not cricket. At least that's what Alan Border and his team are saying over there in Bombay this week as the poor old Aussies start getting the runs before a ball has even been bowled. This afternoon, Richie Beno brings us the pick of the action as our boys take on the Curry Munchers in the World Cup. Plus, we meet the brilliant new Indian batsman, Macau's a bit rusty, who this week notched up a magnificent century in his maiden test. We'll also preview tomorrow's big game between the Pakis and the Poms. So, a big one for cricket fans coming up. For the petrol heads, we'll go rally driving through the Welsh countryside to see how Andrew Cowan not only took out this year's Drivers' Championships, but took out a dozen spectators as well on one of the treacherous corners. Spectacular action! For footy fans, we take a look at how the Banana Benders wrapped up the Rugby League State of Origin series last Tuesday night when they shat all over the boys from New South Wales up there at Lang Park. Plus, we find out just what did happen when our big Darryl Eastlake had his fucking lunch punched out while he was calling the game. Fabulous stuff! After a bit of the usual scintillating repartee with Big Baxi Walker, Lou Richards previews today's big VFL game between the Hawks and the Swans. That ball-chafing Tour de France cycling classic is on again. We'll bring you the highlights of week two as the riders approach the halfway mark. For the Lezos, better strap on the plastic, girls, because we've got more of those female bodybuilders on the show. Plus, we join the big boys, the Super Slobs, as they get set to do battle in this year's grueling Survival of the Fattest. That very rootable darling of the ice, Katarina Witt, skates by. For croquet fans, once again, we'll have fuck all for you on the show. From Rose Hill Racecourse, we'll bring you the last five races live. So, if it's sports you want, you better fucking believe it, it's sports you're gonna get. Because by jingo, by crikey, we've got sports coming out of our arseholes. So, for the next five fabulous days, fill the fridge full of piss and strap into that favourite chair of yours, because here we go again on the one and only Wired World of Sports.
Well, hello and welcome once again to 5 days of sports entertainment on the Wired World of Sports. And what a tremendous week it has been for Australians on the sporting field, especially last night there at the Sydney Entertainment Centre, where Geoffrey Fenech retained his world IBF title when he beat the Mexican-Japanese boxer Zalos Karate. And, Gibbo, that really was a tremendous win by young Geoffrey Fenech.
Yep, by Jingo Zine. He's come of age, young Geoffrey, as a fighter.
Yes, he has.
From the Marrickville Mauler days of a couple of years ago when everyone thought he had a pretty good punch.
Yes.
Well, they weren't too sure that he could go on with it, but he sure gave poor old Karate a real hiding there last night, just like he did with smart-ass Parkeroon a couple of months ago and all the others before him too.
That's right.
There's no stopping him, young Geoffrey.
No, there is no stopping him. It really was a tremendous victory to Geoffrey Fenech.